Hi friends, how are you doing? In this video, I'm going to take you through a quick demo of Vezel, saving your time, and I'm absolutely sure that you will like the tool. So let's start with the dashboard. You see a lot of things happening here, but you can divide this dashboard into major categories. So number one is this part, it's happening in the middle. It comprises of the graphs and numbers. And on the right, you have insights. So let's start with the insights part. So insights is the part which tells you about how you should be using your social media profile. So it tells you that the number of hashtags you should use in your Facebook post, what should be the length of your copy. It should be somewhere between 14 and 35 words. Similarly, it tells you the best time to post, the most applauded content format, the most shared content format, and it does that for each of the social media channel, which is codified according to the color and logo. As you can see in this dark blue, this is for Facebook. Similarly, you get this analysis insights for Twitter, and you get it for Google Plus, and you get it for YouTube as well. And in the center, you see a lot of graphs. But before moving on to graph, I want to tell you how this works. So you have four different brands added here. I will also include Amazon India. So all the data and graphs are taking the data of these five social media channels. And since this is a competitive analysis tool for social media benchmarking, so one of the brand is benchmarked as you. So let's, in this example, Flipkart is the brand which is you, and all the analysis will be according to or keeping this particular brand in mind as the brand which you want to optimize. And how to change this, I will tell you later on, which happens in the landscape section. So starting with the second part of the dashboard, which is graphs, we have compiled the most important graphs, which is crucial for a social media performance. So it starts with brand engagement, and here you can kind of create a benchmark against the best in your industry. So you see you're doing even better than the best among all your competitors. So Myntra is the second one, and how you compare is again the average in your industry. So the average number of engagement a brand is accumulating on social media channels. So in the hashtag section, you can check the most used hashtags right now. So you can check for Twitter, Google Plus, and you can even check it for YouTube. Similarly, you will see these two sections, which is not anywhere else in the tool. So this particular section tells you the most popular content. So you can see 62% of the content posted in your category is from is actually photos. And then it tells you how you compare for this particular content format as compared to the best in your brand, best in your competitors, and the average in your industry. So you can see Flipkart, or the brand which is you, you are using photo content less, but this graph tells you that you should be actually using it more because it's the most popular content format. And then you can see which particular content format is getting the most engagement. So 80% of the content which gets engagement is actually photos. And you can see by increasing your activity here, which was only 226, you can increase this engagement even more. So this is how you can make your graphs insightful. And then the other part of the tool is cross-channel analysis. So here you are actually comparing and getting graphs for each of the metrics here. You can see brand activity, brand engagement, video engagement, fans total, and hashtags. So this is the analysis for brand activity, and you have four sections for each of the metric. The first one tells you overview, so how you compare against the best in your industry and the average in your industry. And it actually interprets the graph for you, which makes it easier. You can even check the lowest performing brand in your industry by clicking on this button. And then the rest of the graphs, the competitive analysis one tells you the actual numbers for each of the brand, and you can even sort it according to the in the descending order. And then there is the timeline graph, and then there is channel share, which tells you the most popular social media channel where the content is being posted the most. And in timeline, you are actually seeing how the activity changes over a period of time, and you can see certain peaks here, and you can try to understand why this might have happened, how you can capture, or you can say capture this moment and try to make quick responses on your social media channels. So these are not just four graphs. So if you see, you can sort or manipulate all this graph according to the content type. So let's say I want to do this analysis for a specific content, let's say video. So all your activity will change according to this particular content format, and you see your graphs have changed suddenly. Your timeline, your channel share, everything will change. So you'll see Facebook is even more important, and Twitter, the video content is almost negligible. YouTube has suddenly become more important in Twitter. So all this kind of analysis you can do for even specific content type. Now we have covered this metric brand activity. We can move on to the other one, brand engagement. So here everything is same in terms of the graph representation, but you can even sort it according to a particular engagement type. So applause, which means number of likes or number of favorites you received on a content, and its submission. Amplification is how many times your content was shared or retweeted, and conversation is how many comments and replies did you receive. So this graph, you can even change it according to these parameters. So let's say I want to see how many comments were received, and you see it suddenly the graph changes. You see Amazon India receiving lots more responses as compared to Flipkart. And competitive analysis, you can check it for individual brands similarly, and you can even see the timeline for this particular activity. And let's say I want to check it for my videos and how people are responding to my videos. You can even do that. So you can see in a single screen, you are getting almost over 30, 40, and I think even 50 more, more than 50 graphs. This is the power of the tool. And you can do this analysis for each of the content or even say metrics, video engagement, fans total, and hashtags. So let's say you want to only compare a particular social media channel. So you can do the individual analysis for social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, but let's say you want to combine two social media channels, Facebook and YouTube, for instance. So you can do that by simply clicking here, or if you want to change the timeline of your graphs, let's say it is from 26th of January, you want it to do only for the last month or the month of June, you can select 1st June, and then you can select 30th June. So all the analysis will be for the month of June. And the power of the tool is, you see the graphs are changing, but the page is not loading, so it is really, really fast. So when your social media marketing manager or social media analyst is going through these graphs, it will be really, really quick for them to do the analysis, saving them time and making their effort more efficient. Another major important tool of aspect of the tool is Smart Insights, where you can do content analysis. So you can see it is right now showing you the latest posts. So let's say you want to see the most popular post which received the most engagement. So you'll see it has changed. And if you want to see a particular post, you can simply click here and see it. Or even if there are videos, some videos, you can play it here directly in the window. Right, so this is another amazing aspect of the tool. And let's say you want to change, do it for a particular engagement type. Let's say you want to see which particular post received the most conversations. You can simply click here, and you can see which content got the most conversations. As simple as that. And you can even do it for a particular content type. So let's say you want to see which particular photos got the most conversations. You can select photos and you will see it. It's telling you with the photos which receive the most conversations. So you can actually do a content analysis, understand which type of content to create. So let's say you want to create the best, the kind of post we get most share, you simply go to amplification and you can create a, and let's say you want to create a video that receives more shares. So you can simply do that by just choosing the video which got the most shares, and you can create some amazing benchmarks for it. These analysis can even be taken further for engagement type. So here you can create benchmarks for particular engagement types, as you can see. And then you can create best time to post. So best time to post is a simple calendar where you see the time you should be posting your content. So you can create this particular chart as a benchmark and create your social media calendar. And insights is a full-fledged form of what I showed you on the dashboard, and you can see access all this analysis here. So now that we have covered the dashboard, cross-channel analysis, and smart insights, I want to take you through another important part, which is reports. So unlike the other tools where you can simply create reports in pre-built format and or remove graphs and you see the end result after you download it, this is a report builder where you can see the actual changes and see the report as it will be when you download it. So this analysis is for Flipkart and Amazon India. So let's say I want to select all the brands. You can do that by clicking here. So you'll see all the brands have appeared, and we have the graphs for brand activity, all the graphs that I showed you earlier, they are available here. Let's say I want to get report for cross-channel analysis. I'll simply select cross-channel. And I want to untick Facebook. So you see the platforms have been removed, and you see the platforms which are included in these graphs. That's the power of the tool, and each graph has its description, which you can remove if you want by clicking intro text. But this has been created by keeping the clients into mind, that most of the times when you're sharing this report with your client, or let's say your CEO, he wants to understand what these graphs means. So this is a really important feature. And let's say another important thing is when people were creating reports, they were not able to add comments. So we have also catered to that. So let's say you want to add comments in brand activity section. You simply click at the drop down here and you can enter whatever you want to. This is an amazing report. So you'll see here a note section has appeared on the page, and you can add whatever you want to checking the graphs. And let's say you want to add or remove a particular graph in a page. So let's say brand activity, we have all the four graphs. Let's say we don't want to include the channel share. You just uncheck it and you see the graphs has been removed. So let's say you also want to add another notes just adjacent to a particular graph. So we have three graphs here. I'll simply click here, and you want to add comments for timeline insights. So the peaks in the graphs were because of a major festival. So you see this particular comment that you have added has appeared just beside the graph. Where earlier what was written was the interpretation of the graph. So that's how easy and effective you can make your reports. And let's say you want to add another page for for the video activity, how are people sharing videos? You simply click the button and you will see another page has appeared. Brand activity for video. And even you can create a combination of certain channels. So let's say the client you are giving your report to, they are not using Google Plus, you can simply uncheck it and your analysis will be only for three of the social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. You can see and verify it by seeing here. You see only three platforms are active right now. And then you can click at the download button and download the report. That's how easy it is. So let's say you want to change the brand in whose reference you were creating all these graphs. So I told you Flipkart was the brand, which was the self brand. And it is signified by its topmost position in the canvas, in the landscape. Let's say you want to make Amazon India as self brand. You can simply click at self and click OK. Page will refresh and in a few seconds, your graphs will appear. You can see we have made Amazon India as our brand. And you see brand selected, Amazon India is your brand now. And you're comparing it all the other ones. The another amazing thing with our tool is the time zone. So normally when you are comparing particular brands, sometimes they appear in different time zones. So let's say you're doing an analysis on sports brand and you want to compare how Nike India is compared against Nike United States, and you can create some benchmarks for the content. You need to actually change it to the time zone it falls in. So normally when you get the reports or let's say monthly reports or weekly or daily reports to your client and you are not taking time zone into account, a lot of things can go wrong. So these time zones were created by their popularity. We have five time zones and you can change all the graphs according to the time zone by changing it here. So that's how easy it is, and I hope you enjoyed seeing the tool. If you have any questions or queries, you can certainly reach our sales team. Thank you for using Vezzle.